Hello folks, and welcome to the Star Wars Galaxies Emulator stream. Give me one second to fix my taskbar so I can see the screen. And there we go. So, we are back to Defoe, and we are back to grinding Pistoleer. Took a day off from combat to explore some crafting. And the first thing I wanted to do, since some people seemed a little confused about the crafting grinding kits, so I wanted to show you where you can get them. So here we are in Tombstone. There's the bank. There's the shuttle. There's our mission terminal we use. There's the med center. And here is the Tombstone Mall. So we hop on in the Tombstone Mall. Go to the right, go to the center in the back, by the Wookiee, and you will see this vendor right here. Crafting grind kits. The Mon Cal standing right here. And if we look at what he has a chef grind kit for 375,000, armorsmith for 700,000, and doctor for 65,000, which also works for combat medic. They're exactly the same. That one is combat medic. You just make less with the combat medic. But you know what? You're making Apex. So you're gonna use them. So you might as well get the doctor one, make some extra ones, and have some left over. Taylor grind kit, 375K. Bioengineer, 375K. Architect, 700K. Artisan, 444. Will take you 25K. And this one will get you any novice box in any crafting specific class, like the ones we talked about yesterday. So if you wanted to become a tailor and you just started, you would buy this for 25K. And then you would buy this to get, and this would get you to the point where you could be a tailor. And then you would buy this at the same time, and this would get you the novice tailor box done. This will take you from novice medic all the way up to being ready to be a doctor in crafting. So it would bring you to the four box in the medic crafting, and this will do doctor. I think we already had one of those. Basically, they're backpacks, and they tell you exactly what you need to make, and they have exactly how much you need in them, plus a little extra in case something glitches. So on this one, if we look at the details, it says contents, 5 crafting tools, and enough materials to reach XXX4 with some extras and a bonus Stimby for medical experience. It tells you to craft bio effect controllers in practice mode. Hey Carson. And that is what I was talking about by the crafting packs. So for those of you watching this in archive, this is where it will be. And you can just go right here and talk to this guy that says crafting grind kits. If you need additional resources, you have high quality resources here, high quality and grind resources here, server best resources here, and grind resources here. And then really cheap 1 CPU resources here. So that's all your crafting resources. These are tools and things like that that you can use. So the crafting stuff's over on that side. The fighting stuff is over on the left side. So that should get you going. Anyway, we are ready to begin. And hopefully we get enough to finish Pistol Grips 2 and Pistol Stances 3 today. That'd be really cool. For those of you who it's the first time watching one of my videos, I stream the entire process of our grind day. And what we do and what we accomplish. Sometimes we get a little distracted and we wander off and do other things. rarely do we spend too much time on it. I try to keep it in track, but it happens. If you are not prepared to watch a 2-hour video, then watch the first 10 minutes and the last 10 minutes, and then you will be caught up to date on what we are accomplishing today and what we accomplished over the course of 2 or 3 hours. Hey, congratulations, Carson. You finished up your character. That is awesome. Good job. Really, really cool. I'm glad to see you playing. So, we are going to take our most profitable mission in a direction that we like. South is good. I do not want those. They're too easy. Northeast sucks. Two backs are good. South. And the next south is weak. That's not too bad. We'll take that one. Hey, Mike. Hey, yesterday was kind of a weird day. It was, I was really focused on the crafting stuff, so there wasn't a lot of, banter like there usually is, because we had a lot to go through to cover the basics of crafting. I know that doesn't interest everybody, but for those people it does interest, they have very few resources to go to learn how to get started. And if it strikes you as being something you want to do, I kind of wanted to make it available to those people so they could have that at their disposal in case they wanted to see what crafting is like in the Star Wars Galaxies universe. People cover it in basics, but nobody really ever takes you through making a product and how to make it better. So we kind of went over that last night. Unfortunately, I talked for 3.5 hours straight and didn't really take a break for anything. Just crafting, running around, doing resource gathering and covering all that stuff. And honestly, we just barely scratched the surface. There is so much more we could talk about in crafting. I probably could have spent all night talking about it and probably not covered everything you need to know. So let's just call that the basic crafting guide and basic resource guide, because if we ever do any more, we'll build on that one. And if we do, it's going to be a while before we get to it, because I got POIs that I got to do, and I got a macro video that I'm going to be working on, and a bunch of other stuff. Trying to get some things in order. Where's a good place to park our bike? Let's see if we can get this to work today. We're going to put all of our armor on so that we're well protected. Make sure we get it all on. We're going to fire up some Viserion brandy so we got some extra mind. While that's loading, we're going to look at a dewback and see that they are vulnerable to acid. Come on, last two pieces. And we're using our DX2. Yeah, it is in depth, and thank you for saying it was a good stream, Mike. At the end of it, I looked at the clock and just went, wow. That was a lot. Okay, so we're going to try and see. We are 40 meters away, lined up with the shelter. So we are going to see if we can take these dewbacks down wearing armor. Because last time we didn't quite get it. And we picked the wrong angle. So we need to line up our dewbacks a little better. And this is what fan shot's useful for, when you have enough defenses not to get yourself killed. It's a forward-facing cone that goes out from your character, so you can see that one on the left is not getting hit at all. So sometimes we need to move to get him back in our firing arc. There we go. That mission's done. We'll leave the baby. We don't have to kill him now, so that's cool. We can leave him for somebody to tame. Alright. Yeah, so I watched his stream today while I was at work and made comments on it. Usually I watch Andrew's streams the next day when I'm at work, and today I was watching it and screwed up and commented with my my work account instead of my home account. But I told him I was down for that if he was interested in having me. So he said yes, so we'll be coordinating that probably a little bit later when he gets on. All right, and now we're going to do the same thing with these Banthas. And just remember, you could see the shot range go from left to right. You can see it sweep. If whatever you're shooting is not in line with your target and that ret shot range, you are going to miss. So you need to stand far enough away and stay lined up so that they come at you in a way that they get in that shot range. See how it sweeps from left to right? You can really see it with the DX2. And sometimes you have to back up a little bit to recenter them. See, there you go. Now we're sweeping left to right, right to left. And the only thing you have to be worried about is when they fall down, the last one falls down, you're going to be targeting the corpse. So you gotta get off that so you target the live one. Next mission down. Done. That's it. That's fan shot. Yeah, Carson, I have a rifleman, combat medic, that I'm probably gonna bring on one day and run around so we can finish up rifleman a little bit. So you guys can see how well that works out. It's really handy. In some cases. In other cases, it's not. And I'll go over the pros and cons of rifleman, combat medic. The real major pro that offsets everything else is that you have two or three different damage type streams for mind alone. So I can poison your mind, I can disease your mind, and poison's going to eat away the points that you have, and disease is going to wound up your mind pool, so you have less mind to have. And then I can, with rifle, I can put a bleed on your mind, and then I can shoot it out. So it works out really well if you're facing like a single target. You can do single target poisons and disease and like area of effect poisons and disease. You can do single target ranged heals and area of effect range heals, and area of effect heals everything in a certain radius around your point where you drop your heal. So if you're in a circle with a bunch of other people and eight of those people are standing in a circle around you at 30 meters and one guy is standing at 35 meters and my heal range is 30 meters from you, then I will heal everybody in 30 meters, but I will not heal that one guy that's at 35. So you kind of got to see where your center is. It's a unique class to play in a group. It's really challenging, but it's really worth it in a lot of cases. I don't want dude and lizards. They shoot stuff at you. Oh, cannibal dewbacks are just as good, so we'll take those. So, south. So they're going to attack us right away. So we're kind of going to be on top of this one. No, I don't want bowcats. No, I do not want desert squill. That's too easy. This'll work. All right. So yeah, sometime in a couple of days, we'll switch out the characters and I'll play the combat medic rifleman for you so you can kind of see how that operates. Then you can make a decision if that's something you want to pursue, because rifle isn't great until you're master, but when you're master, it's awesome. You have to keep a very, very steady stream of ranged weapon speed power-ups on your T21, or use a spray stick if you can find a good one, because it shoots so fast. But your major problem is that most of the T21s have a severe time difference in shooting. So some of them are even 5 rated, which is right up there and higher with some of the very slow two-handed weapons. I think I've seen them even higher than that. I seem to remember seeing some non-quality ones with like 7.3 for speed, and that is not very fast. But at Master, you've got so many mods. I think when you're at Master, if I remember right, you can pick up a rifle speed skill tape of +9 and you will have capped everything you can cap for speed. Hey, David. Welcome back. Is that our mission? It flew over somewhere. I think that's it. Yeah, it looks like it. Cabinal Dewback. We're going to put our bike up here so we can prep. And then we're going to target the rocky shelter. We're going to do the same thing we did last time. Get them as close to lined up as possible and fan shot the crap out of them. Let me fold back a little bit. So it's hard to see on the dewbacks, but you can see the arc going over here. That's our shot area. Anything over here or over here, we're gonna miss. So like this one over here isn't taking any damage. So we'll slide over here so he gets some damage. Gotta spread it around. And now we'll move over here so we can clear up that guy. And there's our last bunch of doobies. Now this is very, very similar to the melee class rare area of effect attack, whatever you're using. And now there are a bunch of cannibal corpse dewbacks. Sorry, bad joke. Okay. So that is really similar to the level 4 box in the melee classes with the the spin attacks that you get in all of these. So that will get you, it takes a lot longer to get it in Pistoleer. You have to get all the way up to here to get that shot. And if, as long as you pair the damage type with a damage that they're vulnerable to, you will just decimate them. But we tried it without armor just to see how much damage we could put out. It was kind of a test. And we got pretty well annihilated because we just don't have enough defenses yet. So we kind of gotta wear the armor, bite the bullet, wear the armor, and go out and just shoot stuff. Alright, so let's line this one up. And then what we're gonna do, this is a good place. Right here. We'll stand right up on this. So we are going to look at our experience, which is, let's get this up on the big screen so you can see it. 132, 614 of 250,000. So 132, 614. And then we're going to start our fan shot. And we're going to time it, so we're 21:44. See how long it takes us to take these guys out. Here's the problem with Pistoleer is you wander because of your dodge. So you've got to recenter yourself so that you're putting that damage out again. I think they're too low of plane, so I think we need to get the Banthas to come up here a little more. Yeah, that was it. There we go, now they're going down. This uneven terrain makes it less than desirable to do it in this place, but so we gotta play around with location just a little bit here. This took a little longer than the other one. So this is not a typical example of this skill. But anyway. Ooh, Dune Lizard sitting over there. Anyway, we got them all. And now we have 153,531, and that took about a minute and a half. We got two missions, so three missions, and we got 50k. So this should speed up our grinding considerably. And once we get stances up to four, we will have the maximum amount of pistol speed we can have, and then we will shoot as fast as we can shoot. Can't ask for more than that. Need to buy faction, Carson? Or are you just looking to earn faction? What rank are you now? One consideration is you might need to make sure that you can hold enough faction to purchase the ATST if you're not high enough rank yet. I don't know that anybody can transfer faction over your cap. So if you're like a private, I don't think you can hold enough for a ATST. So this guy's going to research the breeding habits of mountain dewbacks by having us kill them. That makes no sense. But hey, it's credits, it's experience. We're going to do it. I don't question their methods. No, I don't want desert squills yet. They attack a little too fast for what we're doing right now. Those guys are okay. There we go. Is it? Yeah, it's Sergeant, isn't it? That's high enough for an ATST? For the 15K? You have to go a certain amount of faction and then go to the recruiter and tell them it's time to reevaluate your standing, I think it is, or something like that. I don't remember the exact verbiage. And then they'll say it's time for a promotion or something. I've been gotten promoted in a long time, so I don't remember off the top of my head, but you just need to go see the recruiter. And since you're Imperial, there is a recruiter in Mos Eisley. It's easy to get to. And he also sells all the items too, so you can see what you need to plan out your troop party. They have an Imperial terminal in Tombstone if you need to do missions there too, for whatever reason. If you just want to stay close to civilization while you're doing them, you can take Imperial missions there. Okay, this looks a little bit better terrain for what our purposes are. Although they may, well no, because we're going to be shooting up, so as long as they run at us, we're going to be okay. So we need to get on the other side of this so that they come at us. I think these guys have the same weaknesses as the rest of them with acid, and they do. So we're clear. All right. So let us fan shot. Yeah, Sergeant at 36,000 would be enough to hold the... Oh, man. Quit knocking me down. Ain't nobody got time for that. You can also run missions off the Imperial base on Dantooine. I had really good luck running them there. It seemed like I got a good bit, and the missions were close, and they were fairly easy, paid really well, gave out good amounts of faction, and weren't too hard. So that was one of those kind of... I always ran them from there. It was easier. Oh, got caught shooting a corpse. We are now minus some Mountain Dewbacks. That was a good bit of experience. So now we're at 179, 275, it looks like. It really depends on the difficulty of the mission you take as far as how much faction you get from it. And your rank also has some bearing, I believe. Alright. Remember I told you guys sometimes you get stuck in gullies? And you can't go anywhere. Right now we're stuck here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna leave the vehicle and see if we can walk. We can't walk. So let's get this out of our way. Let's store it. Now what we're gonna do, sit down. Hopefully we should drop. There we go. And now we can stand up. And we didn't get it. So let's sit down again. Color bike. There we go. We got unstuck. Just had to wait a second. It's the game slowing us down. We're moving too fast. Anyway, I had mentioned that before. If that ever happens to you guys, all you have to do is pretty much get off your vehicle, store it, and then sit down a couple of times, see if that fixes it for you. If that doesn't fix it for you, call your vehicle again, see if you can mount it in a different location, and that'll usually get you unstuck. If that doesn't get it, log out for about 20 seconds, log back in, and see if that'll get it for you. Those are the little tricks about getting stuck on a rock, basically. Okay, guess they decided this is a good place for us to get off. Which is good enough for me. Slash stuck doesn't always work. I tried it last time and it moved me right to where I was already stuck. But that what I went through, it's rare. I mean, it's really rare that that happens. But if it ever does happen to you, those are the steps that I go through to get unstuck. And I've had it happen 3 times on Tatooine in a year, and 1 time on Endor. Other than that, never had it happen. that is another mission down. And now we are 205 of 250. So that was 30k. That wasn't too bad. Now we'll just barrel back, grab another mission, head on out. But the ATST will help you get better missions in general, so definitely going to be a boost to how much you pull in, because you can get some crazy difficult missions with an ATST on your side. I kind of wish they had made an equivalent thing for the Rebels. But I really don't think there is anything specifically directly correlating to a Rebel pet you can get that's as practical and useful as an ATST. Yep. I remember getting stuck on those rocks and being stuck in the Night Sister's cave and ending up teleporting down to the center of the earth and getting sent back to 0.0000 on the on whatever planet. Live had these problems too. This isn't specific to the emulator. It did this often on Live as well. You would run in, sit down somewhere, and then you would zip back outside. Because that was where the server tracked your last location. Now, when the Live servers were up, when the Geonosian caves went in, they actually implemented the Geonosian caves and then sealed the door with a red barricade like this one. Now, I guess the penalty for revealing my secret is over since the Live servers are down. But we would walk up to the barricade and unplug our cable modems, and then we would walk through the barricade into the Geonosian caves, plug our cable modems back in, and it would update your location, reconnect, and you would be inside. So we did that for like a week before the Geonosian caves open. And believe me, I was not the only one doing it, so. Bulbanthas. And there's no need to worry about revealing that little secret here, because the Geonosian caves are already implemented and there probably isn't going to be any new areas we have to worry about being blocked from. So, yeah, we'll just tear up these Rontos, so we're good there. Somebody ran behind me, I think. So the Live servers used to have a pretty serious problem with the location of where your character currently was in the game. There was a lot of warping, there was a lot of whatnot to where you'd jump ahead or jump back, rubber band. So it was a little vague on exactly where you were. It worked off the principle of close enough, I think. I think I turned off my overhead. Yep, I did. Yeah, I don't think anybody cares anymore, David. I mean, all the people that would worry about it would prosecuting me for cheating are pretty much moved on to something else. Yeah, we had a whole bunch of Acklay stuff. already made before they, before the geocaves were even put in. Needless to say, the devs were a little puzzled as to how we got that done. I'm pretty sure we were under surveillance for a while after that. Can't let these guys feel excluded. Can't shoot a corpse. He was just outside of the range. Done. Now we'll move on to our actual worthwhile target. We need just a little bit more defense before we start going after the mountain squirrels. We just can't quite get them yet. We're close, though. I mean, we're really close. Get a nice, even location, like right here. And then we'll just, take out all these little banthas. Move along, little bantha. The bantha herders. I'm not sure how many boxes we're going to get through tonight. We're just going to keep going until we're done. We're more on a time schedule tonight than a quest to do anything in particular. Just get as much as we can. Because I would like to spend next week doing the theme parks. So, that means we're going to have to be pretty far along in combat skill to start doing those. I mean, we're close. We could probably do the theme parks now, but I would rather finish this and not have to worry about it. Because I would really hate to start one of those and get stuck in a challenging spot in a theme park and not be able to keep past it and have to stop. And I don't remember the difficulty levels of everything in every theme park off the top of my head anymore. So, we're pretty close. I mean, as soon as we master Pistoleer, we're in the clear to start them. And once we master Pistoleer, we're going to be pretty well on the way to Smuggler and TKA, Tereska Sidemaster. For sure. Because all the Pistoleer combat experience is going into that, so that will help us out tremendously as well. I mean, really, I'm just trying to stay ahead of Andrew, because, you know, he's catching up to me. It's a race, I guess. Unofficial race. The Star Wars Galaxies Challenge. That'd be something, wouldn't it? Start a new character every time the other person gets a box. Everybody else has to eat a spoonful of wasabi or something. Of course, I'd be down with that because I like wasabi, so. Maybe we could substitute hot sauce or something. Somebody pick a hot sauce that they think is hot, and we'll do that. You know, first person and novice, whatever, you know, has to do something, or everybody else has to do something when the first person gets there. That'd be kind of fun, I think. I think when they do a server wipe, when they put the new server in, whenever that is, we're gonna have to keep that in mind. Get everybody together and do it as like a challenge. I talked to a little bit in Andrew's stream yesterday. For anybody who is either doing or interested in doing streaming or recording Star Wars Galaxies but has been having a lot of trouble, probably this weekend I'm going to sit down, and I've got a lot of things planned to do this weekend, so we'll see if I get through all of them. I'm really hoping I can do it this weekend. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go over my setup for how I record, and then my settings in Galaxies to make it easier. And I will probably also do a really quick "this is my system" type thing, so you guys can see what I play on and what it, you know, really takes to play some of these games and record and everything. Because I get asked from time to time what kind of computer that I have, and I thought if I put it up in a video, it just answers some questions that some people have had. And I've still got to paint my room in here so we can turn the camera on once I figure out how much lighting I'm gonna need. Where did our mission go? Dang, it just jumped all the way over there. Alright, there's our mission. There's our rocky shelter. Fire them up. Yep, there we go. We got that box. Of course, then again, at the rate we've been going, it's inevitable that we would have gotten it. Yeah, I just know that a lot of people are always really curious about people's computers, and especially people who stream and people who make YouTube videos, just to show you what goes into a system to be able to render videos reasonably, and you know what that entails. Because I was not able to render videos clearly until I got, I think I started being able to get them clear at about 24 gig of RAM dedicated to Premiere when I was using Premiere. So if I had anything less than like 24 gig of RAM just dedicated to Premiere, it would just chug along and take hours. But once I got over 24 gig, it wasn't too bad. And believe me, it'll use every piece of memory you throw at it. Even if it's just wasting it, it'll tie it up. Your system is tipping. Oh, there we rubber band all the way back there. Your system will just stop, basically. I'll be rendering a video and think, you know, I want to play Diablo or something real quick while this is... Oh, yeah, I can't. And then once I render the videos on the ones that I do edit, I send them to another computer that... sets the scaling and everything, and then automatically uploads them to YouTube. And that's why some of my videos show up at like 3 in the morning or whatnot. And hey, good news, my Halloween song got the content ID strike removed today, so that went on just in time for Veterans Day. But hey, at least it's before Thanksgiving. I thought they were going to wait the whole 30 days. So if you like electronic music or ambient, you know, give it a listen. I actually like that one. It's kind of fun. We run them back and forth. If you wanted to do this with things that were more challenging than you can handle, you could technically kite them and do this, because that would put them in a straight line. So that would work really well if you were trying to take something that was very difficult. So, so we got this guy, so if he was chasing us, we can do that, oops, or this, or whatever, and keep shooting him in a row so we would hit them all. And if they were NPCs and we were using Snowcake for dodge, they probably would never hit us. Especially if we're higher in Pistoleer, they would never touch us, so we could do that halfway across the planet and kill just about anything. That's how a lot of bounty hunters run missions. They get all jacked up on dodge food, and then they just aggro their target and run in a straight line and keep bleeding it with their pistol. Sometimes you have to. I mean, when you're running like a 255 difficulty mission, you're not standing toe-to-toe with that guy. You just use whatever resources are at your disposal. So you get creative. I think those are Tuscans, and I think they're Tuscan warlords, so... That's a gambler. There were some Tuskens out here earlier. All right. Let's go to town. And train. How much money would we made? About 60,000, I think. It's not too bad. All right. So, I will just say this again, just because it seems like I didn't quite get the info to some people. The Bounty Hunter and the Pistoleer Trainer. There's the Smuggler Trainer back there. Bounty Hunter, Pistoleer Trainer, right here. They're having a cold drink under the blanket, or under the canopy, out here in the back of the cantina. We want grips too. Yes. Okay. And we are already 40,000 into our 350,000, so I think we can get Pistol Grips 3 done as well tonight, if we keep rolling. That should not be much of a problem at all. I did not want inventory. I wanted that. Yeah, there's the Tuscan guards. They're over there. So yeah, once we finish this box, we should start being able to get better missions on Dantooine, so next episode, I really expect we'll be on Dantooine. And then that will make the Yavin POI video that we're doing this weekend easier, because we will have considerably more dodge. So we can finish up these two boxes of dodge, we will be able to do the Yavin POI video without worrying about getting clipped by the Clicknicks. It's harder to say than I thought it was going to be. Alright, let's see if this gave us any more difficult missions. I'm just making up words now. Cannibal Dewbacks, they were worth a good amount of experience. We'll take that one. And North, what are you? Cannibal Dewbacks. We will take you and we will decannibalize the Dewbacks. They're both fairly close so far. So this week's just flying by. And I know a lot of you guys are in other countries and whatnot, but tomorrow is Veterans Day here in the United States, so I just want to take a minute and thank all our veterans for their service. And veterans anywhere, actually. Doesn't matter what country you're in, you did something you believe in, so good for you. I don't believe anybody should be held responsible for doing something they believe in just because they're from a different place. You stood up for your country and you stood up for yourself. Good enough. This one's right here. We can take it out real quick. Just need to make sure we're in the right position for it. All however they line up. We'll just take them out. First year in a long time you weren't home for Remembrance Day. I believe you're always at home, no matter where you are, as long as you are thinking of the people who are at home that are important to you for those holidays. So even if you can't be there, you're there in spirit. I don't want to get into a big discussion about military and politics, and because I could care less about politics. I'm not political. But I have a lot of strong feelings about military, so especially in the way people who serve in the military are treated when they're treated poorly. Yeah, I haven't been out of this country in a long time. I really like Canada, though. It was very entertaining. Nice place. Saw a lot of weird things there. Of course, I was driving up the Alcan Highway, so you see a lot of weird things there anyway. It's just a trail of weird. Now, is Remembrance Day tomorrow in Canada? Not familiar with a lot of the global holidays. Although I should be, but I'm not. So, I apologize for that, but it's a great way to work up battle fatigue and stuff. Probably my favorite place in Canada would either be Prince Edward Island or the Yukon Territory. We drove through the Yukon in December. And we were up in the mountains, and I was following a semi-truck through the snow, which had blanketed the road so clearly you could not see anything resembling road, and it was so bad, the semi-driver decided to wave me ahead of him so he could follow me instead of me following him, because he thought maybe I had an idea where I was going. Well, I sure didn't. But I made it. It was a really fun. It was an interesting trip. We'll say that. I spent some time in Alaska, and that was different. And no, I never met Sarah Palin or any of those people that came from there. But it was quite the place. But generally around that time period, I spent a lot of time in deserts. So going to Alaska from being in the desert was kind of a switch. I think we can do better than that. Yes, we can. All right, west. West it is. Yeah, I don't think that's going to be hard enough. And they have range, so they never come at us. Those aren't hard enough. That might be. Yep, good enough. Yeah, Yukon in the winter, and they're telling me I'm a brave guy. We actually stopped in Whitehorse because that was as far as we were legally allowed to go that night. And they'd closed the road, told us we couldn't move forward it anymore, so we had to get a hotel in Whitehorse. And it dropped down to 46 degrees below zero that night, and the car totally froze up, and we almost had to have it towed into the shop and defrosted so that we could start it after sleeping for 3 hours and drive the rest of the day. It was extremely cold. But this was in Whitehorse in the Yukon Territory. I drove up to Canada, or up through Canada in October the year before, and drove back down in December the following year. So I was up there about a year and year and a couple months. And it was an experience. I don't ever want to drive that way again, but I've seen things that you would never see if you haven't driven up there. But there are really some of the nicest people up there. They're always willing to help out. All through there, I never felt like anything was out of control. And you look around, and it is wilderness. It is complete wilderness with. If there was a place you were going to get ambushed on the road and have all your stuff stolen and all kinds of bad things happen to you, from the appearance, that would be one of those places. But everybody there was really nice, you know, and really mindful of telling you about things you need to be aware of coming up. It was really a good encouragement in human spirit. And you're right, never underestimate the value of a block heater. If I hadn't been planning to move back to the southwest, I probably would have had one installed, but I bought the car right before we left, and it wasn't supposed to get cold, and it did. And then got held up longer than I thought. And next thing I know, we're leaving in December. So it was an interesting part of my life. There were a lot of interesting parts of my life. Got to see a lot of things, do a lot of things. I've been really fortunate. And I don't regret a single thing. I think that's the problem. If you have regrets, they're going to stick with you. If you have good memories and you can hold on to those and just forget about the things that bothered you, it's a lot easier getting through life. we go. Yeah, actually, in the next couple videos, I'm going to start posting some of my social media links. So if you guys are curious to find out more about me specifically, you'll be able to look at those. Maybe that'll answer some of your questions. Or maybe it'll make more questions. I'm not sure which. Synchronized dewback dancing. Give these guys over here some attention. Get rid of this guy because he's almost gone. There we go. Now we just got these two guys. Yeah, someday maybe I'll tell you about my trip up to Alaska and what an ordeal that was. You'll be laughing a lot during that one, but it's got to be the right setting to talk about that one. It would require maps and whatnot, but it was an interesting trip. And we're done again. And look at that, we're already at 145,000 to 350,000. So we're almost at 50%. And we're just, that was 12 minutes, so. If we can keep this up, we're gonna be through Pistoleer really soon. And the good part is once we're done with Pistoleer, we'll just rock through Smuggler real quick, and while we're doing that, it will give us the precision striking tree and TKA. A stream of the PowerPoint. Yeah, I bring slides, that's no problem. I wish I still had some of the pictures I took, but you know, the whole preface of that trip was the first thing I saw when I crossed over into Canada, into Vancouver. I was driving for about a half an hour, and I was getting to the point where I was going to have to stop for gas anyway, but the entire highway was on fire, and I got a little concerned about that, because highways usually aren't on fire, and I stopped at the gas station, and I said, somebody might want to call somebody, you know, your highway is on fire, and they said, no, we do that, that's a controlled burn to take out the forestry. So next year it'll be ready for them to replant. Only place I've ever been where they have a wildfire running and aren't even concerned about it. Very calm. It was reassuring. And that started off my trip. Banthas to the south. They seem to be worth a decent amount of experience. And there is Rontos. They're worth a good amount. Fair amount. They're not great, but a well-paying mission is going to have more stuff in it. So we may work out averaging better for that one. But on the plus side, we're making tons of money. So we'll be able to afford that 1 million credit gun really soon. Of course, I don't have a 1 million credit gun in mind, but hypothetically, if we wanted one, we could buy 10 pairs of VKs for TKA or a lightsaber crafting kit. pre-winter heating auction. That's good. I mean, you know, you got to warm the earth so it'll stay warm, right? Cover it up with a blanket and keep it nice and warm. I think that's the trick. I'm not sure. I'm not an expert. This will work out well as long as we can get right down here on this little section. It'll run right up this little path to us, I hope. That'll put them on even ground. Because remember, when they were lower than us, we couldn't target them as well. So this should put them right where we want them. We'll get just a little more. There we go. So they'll cover the ridge. There we go. Now they got a good way to run up to us too, so they'll sit in our cone longer. Yeah, we're just racking up the battle fatigue and the wounds. Some entertainer is going to be really happy to see us. But if we do this for a few hours, we could get up to 900. Get some poor entertainer all the way to master. It's a public service, right? That one down, that one's down, and that one's going down. Good night, Bantha. Thank you. This adventure brought to you by Armor. Keeps you standing. And Dr. Buffs. Otherwise, you wouldn't be able to wear your armor. Did we cover that? Did we ever cover the effects of armor? I don't know that we did. I mean, is there really that much of a need to show how armor works? I'm not sure. I think it's kind of self-explanatory to me, but do you think, you guys think I need to make a short video sometime about, you know, how to look at armor and things? What the resists are for and what the encumbrance is going to do? Or is that pretty easy to figure out? Yeah, sometimes I feel weird about making some videos about certain things because either I think nobody wants to know about that or everybody knows about that. But I'm not everybody, so it's kind of hard for me to tell if you guys have any interest in it or don't understand it. Certainly want to make sure we cover it, so we just got to get through the list of requests I already have. We'll get those done so I can get caught up. And then we'll start another list. Yeah, he did one. Mobius did one. He was sitting outside the cantina when I was coming by this afternoon. Or, well, this evening. Oh, eating up a mind. Not sure what he was doing. Maybe he was researching, sitting outside the cantina. His last few videos have been a little weird. It's like he was trapped in a bathroom or something. And we are done. Back for another set. Where's that put us? Pistoleer. Grips. 185 of 350. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna have a problem making that box today. And stances is at... Is that 86 or 96? I can't see it. 86 of 120. So we need about 400,000 combat or pistol experience in order to get that box. So we'll get there. We'll definitely get there by the time we get pistol grips 4. And we'll probably finish off the last box when we get to marksmanship 4. Which isn't going to take much time at all. Yeah, Mobius is really... He was really invested in that, so... Emotionally and... I think financially, too, so... When the North Isley Mall went out of business, he's... He's being impacted by that directly. He's a really good guy. I really enjoy his videos. I really do. I recommend, if you're not watching them, that you definitely go check out his stuff. He is very concise and very direct and has a very nice way of explaining things. He gets straight to the point. I kind of meander and wander around and eventually we find the point. But he's really good at getting his thoughts through and telling you what you need to know. The only thing that was that I could say about his videos as to why I started doing mine after watching his was that he doesn't have a schedule. So he plays a little less often than I do. And there's nothing wrong with that at all. But sometimes I think you guys want more than one video every 3 weeks. Yeah, Cornet Mall. I don't know why people like that place. I went there and oh my gosh, the prices were high. Combat roll. Not sure what you mean, David. Specifically. Do you mean like dive shot and things like that? Or are you talking about something else? Yeah, Mobius makes awesome videos and he's a really nice guy, really patient. He and I talked a little bit off and on when I first started. Nothing serious, it's just more saying hi to him, and he's always been extremely pleasant to me, so that was very encouraging when you see somebody that does something that you like and they acknowledge you and they're nice people when you meet them. It always sucks when you have a celebrity or someone you enjoy their work, like a musician, even if it's a local musician, and you enjoy what they're doing, and then you meet the person and they're a complete jerk. And that's not the case with him. He's just an all-around nice guy. I've only seen him use a harsh tone with somebody one time, and they totally earned it. Negation and damage rolls. Okay, I think I know what you're talking about. I just wanted to make sure we were talking about the same thing. Yeah, I'll probably get to that when we have more available types of ways to put damage down and to mitigate damage and things of that nature. And I need to script that one because I need to have the absolute facts in front of me. So I'll probably be working on that one eventually, but that's going to be a little involved. So we'll get there. Before we get there, though, I want to explain special multipliers on special attacks. So I need to get a sampling of those, and I'm going to put those in a Google Sheets worksheet, and then I'm going to share it for you guys. So if you want to look at it, you can open it while we talk about it and follow along. So we'll probably do that one as a stream, even though it really doesn't have to be. But I'm going to get all the multipliers, like where fan shot is times 3.5 or whatever the actual value is, and then explain what that means, and then have a sheet with every class, with every multiplier for every special. So you guys can have that. Once you have that, that's like the basis of understanding factoring in whether your move is more efficient or not. As we did a little bit about that the other day when we were comparing the different pistols, and I showed you the speeds and I showed you the damage types basically, and I showed you the difference between like a base shot and a special shot. So yeah, it is included, but I think that's, when you take it down to it, I think that's where you need to start. You need to understand how that all relates to it, because you can't really explain the rest until you understand where the damage is coming from. At least that's how I feel. I mean, it may be a little misguided, but that's kind of how I feel about it. You got to understand that part before you go talking about other things regarding damage in the game. So I'll get that spreadsheet together at some point, and we'll do like a seminar on it where we're not necessarily playing the game, but we're discussing the game at a more technical level. Because it does help. It helps to understand what shots do what shots are broken, what ones are ineffective, what ones have additional benefits, what ones have other stuff. And different things like that. So I will probably pull the numbers from back when Live was around. There was a Star Wars Galaxies site attached to the Stratix.com site that had all that information readily available, and I think I have it archived somewhere. And the reason being is because that will have the pre-CU damage modifier tables. So there won't be any confusion between the damages from pre-CU to combat upgrade to the NGE. Yeah, it's definitely worth looking into. You're definitely right, David. It's something that is really helpful to understand. It's just intimidating to start that whole process, because where do you really begin? Because to me, what makes the most sense was to start at how the damage gets applied and take it back from there to how it is, or how it, from how it is applied to how it lands. So I'm kind of getting an idea how I want to do it, and once I've got that, we'll get it together. But yeah, it is something you definitely want to know about. Grizzled Dewback. I wonder if we can take him. I think we did. I don't think we're gonna worry about him. They're not worth that much more than these guys. We're plowing through these guys, so let's go grab two more missions and call it good. Yeah, there's a lot of those tables out there, and it's really handy to cover and understand. So I don't think a lot of people who played ever really understood it. I know a bunch of people who did understand it, of course, because they put out these articles. But I think a lot of people who played the game honestly played the game because it was Star Wars. They didn't play the game because they were interested in figuring out min-max and stuff. So, but it is helpful to learn in the end game what shots do what and why you would want to use them if there was a special case where you wanted to apply something. But we need more of a variety, for example. And we'll get that. We'll get there. Just need to be able to show you guys examples of stuff. And like I said, the worst part about Star Wars Galaxies is there's no practice dummies. So, like in other games, you can get a practice dummy that is never going to die, and you can just shoot it or hit it or whatever, cast spells at it, whatever you do, and then use a combat analyzer to see how you did. And this doesn't have that, so. Yeah, it goes deep. It really does. That whole, combat analysis goes really deep, so I think Dune Banthas were easier than other ones. Whatever, we'll send them back to the Bantha Maker. Is it Southwest? Yeah, I think it was Southwest. That one's gonna be too easy. That one's going to be not useful for what we're doing. We'll do this one. Yeah, add it to my long list. My list keeps getting longer. I really need a weekend where I can make a bunch of videos on stuff and get them ready and have time to edit them properly. And then upload them as I go. So I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna do that. Gonna do a string of videos. And we're gonna put them over the course of time, and use them like bonus episodes during the middle of the week and stuff. But I think when we get our like a holiday weekend, and I get a 3-day weekend, we're gonna make some real progress. So on that, we'll get all caught up. But right now, I'm just having fun playing, so I'm all talked out from last night. That was a lot. Was totally worth it, putting all those thoughts down, getting them on a recording, even if it wasn't scripted. It's trying to stay coherent, but going from topic to topic is much through progression as I could think to do so. And sometimes you just sit down and talk about something, and you're just so it's so hard to find the starting point. So hopefully I manage that without going too far off track. Where is it gonna go? Use the Dune Banthas. They look even easier than the Bull Banthas. Ha ha ha. Seems like I was a little bit too boring there for you, I guess. Or hey, maybe you're an insomniac and I helped you go to sleep. These guys aren't worth as much, I don't think. Yeah, 960. They're not quite worth as much, but it looks like there's more of them, so maybe that works to our advantage. Yeah, I was really tired, Tuesday. Got stuck in traffic on the way home. Took me about an hour and 45 minutes to drive home on Tuesday. I got home and pretty much ate something and got straight on here. And I think we stayed on a little later than usual. Tuesday and Wednesday. And I was really tired this morning. 4 o'clock rolled around and wow. I was ready to hit the snooze bar for another couple hours. Hello, Squill. You are at the top of this mountain, so we're going to need to find a better place to shoot you guys from. How about here? Okay, so let's get your little nest thing targeted. Let's put you in a situation where you're going to have to come over this ridge all the way. There we go. Now these guys are worth it. Really wish it wouldn't target the corpse when something else was attacking you. That always seems to get me. See, wow. Wow. Look at that. 273 or 350. So, like, 39 minutes. And we have almost made this box. Yeah, David. Probably starting tomorrow, I'm going to reorganize my description boxes to put my social media page links in. So you can send me a friend request on Facebook from there. And I'll be happy to answer any questions you have about anything. Hey, Teo. Yeah, I keep forgetting to do that. I keep forgetting to put those on there. Put my Twitter, my Facebook, my Steam. Actually, a lot of people probably wouldn't be interested in adding me on Steam and watching things that I play, because you can see them before I record them, actually. Because I always do anyone can watch any game I play option. Yeah, those squills really boosted us, I think. But they're like 1,300 a piece, and there were a bunch of them, so that was huge. I was kind of disappointed in the Dune Banthas. They didn't give us much at all, but those squills just shot that line up. And that's the key thing of working fan shot up first as a pistolier, because it allows you to take out nests like that. A lot of the other range professions don't really give you a really good way to do that until even later. So like rifleman, you don't get a really good way to do it until master. Then you're really not looking for experience, but you can take down nests like crazy. Like you can take down an entire nest on Dantooine in under 15 seconds, I'm guessing. Because you just put out an extreme amount of damage. Let's see if we get another squill mission. Dewback. Cannibal Dewback. Those are good, but we can do better. Cannibal Dewback. No, we're doing worse now. There's a squill mission. South. Okay, so we need south. And we'll do back. Desert EOP. We don't want to screw those guys now. We're a little past them. Mountain Warts? No. Desert EOP. Mountain wart. It's going to be a bunch of mountain warts, though. For 9,000. Rontos. These are going to be too easy. Too easy. Desert EOPs. There we go. This should be something. We'll take this one. They're not horrible. Yeah, school missions seem to give us a lot. We'll see. We'll do this one as a litmus test, because we'll see if it raises it as much as the last one did. So I'm pretty sure that's what did it. And if that's the case, then this should finish the box. So we'll train two boxes, and then we'll be on our way towards that fourth box with our highest level dodge until master. And at that point, you get to be almost untouchable as a pistolier. This dodge is really, really good. Some of the damage avoidance skills in this game are really good. Some of them are not quite as good. And maybe we'll have an opportunity to go through what each one of those does at some point. But see, dodge is good because you avoid the damage. I think it's block or counterattack where you take half the damage, so you still take damage. Alright, these are probably... What are you? Bowcats? I don't want to mess with you guys again. Dwarf Nunas. So probably that was probably the Ronto mission it offered us, was over there. These should be the squills. Yep, I can tell by the nest already. Let's get even as close as we can be. And this point will be higher than them. That may work. Okay, so remember 273, 762. Like a stampede, a squillpede. Put us at 297 of 350. That doesn't seem that much higher out of normal. I guess it's just the accumulation of the missions we've had that has just really made it go up. But they're still not bad. And they die quick enough, so most everything does when you throw acid at it. Barring a few things that are either resistant to acid or invulnerable to acid. Cannibal Duvax. Alright, Rocky Shelter. Oh. Are they under a cone? Yes, they are. Yeah, block and glancing blow. Excuse me. Are a percentage of the damage. I'd always rather avoid all of the damage than either reflect some of it or only take a partial. But then again, if you've got enough mitigation on top of it, it really doesn't matter. And those are one pile of dead dewbacks. Nap time. Done. 321. So one more mission set and we'll have trained this box. This one's rolling right along. Get another 200k, we can train that one. It's like 10 missions, I think. Average. But probably a little less, maybe 8 or 9. Did we miss one? I'm not going back for them, we don't need them. Always leave one survivor so he can tell the tale. I think I learned that from Conan. Anybody here play Age of Conan? I actually kind of enjoyed that game. I think I played it when I was temporarily banned from EverQuest for something stupid.
Southwest. Bowcats. I just don't like bowcats because they have a ranged attack, so they never get close enough to you. And they can stay outside your cone. That's why we're not taking them. They're worth quite a bit of experience. Southwest. Southwest. But they don't come to you. They'll stand away from you and shoot you. So they're not the best missions for this. Same with these guys. Even though we're getting more of them, they may live outside our cone and they have no aspirations to move into it, so it's likely we would never damage them. Southwest is kind of barren. There's one. I'm not taking bowcats. Sorry. I'm just not doing it. I will let this planet get overrun with bowcats because I'm not killing them. Let's go. Yeah, I had fun in Age of Conan up to about the time you got out of the beginner's area. After that, it was kind of blah. But the starter area in Age of Conan had probably one of the better storylines when I played it of any of the MMOs that were out at the time that it came out. After that, it was just a hack and slash, but before that, you actually had a purpose, and it was kind of cool. And they started to use some of the more unique mechanics, like sneaking around and things like that. So that made it interesting. But it was still in that time period where none of that had been perfected yet. So it was a good attempt, but needed more work. I haven't played it recently. I got invited to again. I had written some letters to Funcom to get permission to do Let's Plays on some of their products. And they were more than happy to let me do that one, or Age of Conan, or Anarchy Online, or any of the other products that I asked. They're a really good company. Their legal department was really nice to work with. They've got that game Secret World now. I haven't tried that one. I remember when it was coming out, there was a really big deal about the advertising for it. And then the game took so long to come out, I had pretty much forgotten about it by then. And after that, I was playing something else. So sadly, they were not going to be my game of choice. You guys are not on our plane. We need to restack these dewbacks. Because he's not taking any damage. So that's the only thing you need to watch when you do this, is that you don't have one that's gone invulnerable because he's outside your cone. Or he's too high, or he's too low, and he's not taking damage. So you gotta watch these. Just make sure they're going down. Well, that one ran off to fight something. Nobody's fighting. I can't see. Something. He coming after us now? What did he kill? I don't see anything over there. Oh well, not important. We're going that way, so... I'm sure the corpse has already vanished. Huh. It's a mystery. We've almost got our rocks. 3,000. We'll definitely get it on this one. Oh, our empty cage didn't sell. We're gonna have to go pick that up tomorrow. I'll show you how to pick up unsold items at the merchant terminal or the bazaar terminal tomorrow. Probably should have left that so I didn't forget it. Because if you don't pick them up, they'll disappear. So if it's something of moderate value, it's in your best interest to go get it if it doesn't sell. In this case, we were selling it for 100, so I don't care. Because it was just for an example, but if it was, say, a 15k item or a 20k item, then we would definitely want to make sure we go reclaim our property. There we go. Got our box now. That one's coming along pretty good too. Gotta go greet this last guy. Not leaving any squills left alive. No, sir. Mostly because they're worth too much. All right, let's go train our box. So now we'll be even more dangerous because that will give us body shot 3 and dodge plus 20. And the next one is the last 20 and point blank area 2, which it could be useful, but fan shot is generally more predictable. And we'll cover all that in the discussion of multipliers and damage rolls and things like that. Thank you. I still like to think we're all building this character together, so since you guys have been involved pretty much every step of the way, it's kind of like this is a team effort, so congratulations to you guys too. Now once we get this box and get the dodge all the way up, some of the accuracy might be useful for fighting stuff, but these are what's gonna help us out in damage resistance. So if we can get here and try to get this box done, we'll be in really good shape to do the rest of those POIs, and maybe we can try to sneak in and get the Tuscan POI. Maybe we'll have enough dodge to dodge the shot to run through this time. Or we can just continue finishing it, and then we'll be at maximum. We don't really need the Tuscan pool for a POI, because eventually we're going to get the Dathomir Sarlacc. So that will be our other difficult POI. So we'll be covered there. And I'm pretty sure some of the ones on Yavin are also considered difficult. So we'll have the difficult ones done. That one will just be one we probably go clean up afterwards. There's nothing like getting shot in the head 10 times in 2 seconds for 5,000 damage. We'll probably stock up on some either dodge food or damage resistance food or both before we try that one again. Because all you gotta do is run to the POI. You can get killed at the POI. You just gotta get there. Oh, that's what happened. Our mind buffs ran out. I was like, where'd our mind go? Grips. 8,000. Done. And done. So, let us go get our mind buffs back, because we're not going to be able to proceed too much further until we do. See, Norcus is back. So that's useful. There we go, and listen to the musician, and we will watch the dancer. Take a little spin around the room, see who's here. Nobody I recognize off the top of my head. Probably if we go in the cantina, there'll be some people. Yeah, I would like to get stances 3 done tonight, at the very least. Because if we can get that, we'd be in great shape. Because that'll give us more melee defense, more accuracy while standing, and more pistol speed and pistol melee defense too, which is basically build is similar to pistol melee defense 1, only betterer. And then we'll get the last melee defense and pistol speed, and then that's all we got until master. But that uses all our combat experience, and then we can start putting our combat experience in here. And that'll give us a lot of defense when we start TKA. And hey, if we can get a good distance through Grips 4, then that puts us well ahead, and we know what we're in for tomorrow. We could probably do most of this whole tree in one day, especially if we shoot a little faster. So 170-ish K combat pistol experience to finish that box off, and then this one's going to be 1.5 million pistol experience to get 150,000 combat experience. almost done. Actually, that's probably enough. We're probably not going to go the whole 2 hours, so I'm sure we're not. It'll be really late. Let's see what we get from that. Oh, we got the whole thing. There we go. Even though they're bots, make sure you leave something for them because they are here for you. Is Mobius still over here? Nope, he moved off. He was sitting right here last time I ran by. Ooh, our bike needs a tune-up. I kind of wish it was that easy to fix your car in real life. You just pull up, pay some credits, and all the fire goes away. It's not so easy in real life. Usually fire doesn't go away. So our 6 pistol speed actually going to help us? No. Maybe a little. Until we hit 50, it's not going to matter. Okay. I don't want east, but west. All right, west it is. No, that's gonna be too easy. Nope. Close enough. What are we doing money wise? Not bad. $500,000. I think we started with like 335,000. So this has been fairly profitable. We need to drop about 2.3 million on containers, I think. Probably way off on that math. Those are 20k each. I think you need like 30, but I could be wrong. We just need to get that first box train, then the rest is easy. There's our dewbacks. I wonder if they're all from this nest. I think so. There's quite a few of them. Yeah, we're gonna master TK. In hindsight, we probably should have done that first. But pistols presented itself as an easier path for us at the time. But with all the defenses we have, we should be in fair shape. Shouldn't be too horrible to do it. If we would have mastered TK, we would have been able to do all the theme parks by now, because of the high level of defense the TK gets. But I really wasn't in a hurry, so. And honestly, it's for me, it's all about enjoying the whole trip of the character. And as far as I know, they do not have a solid release date set for Jedi yet, so as it stands, we've got loads of time, so who knows how many loads of it, but we've got all the time we need to play around. Surprise mission. Gotta target your rocky shelter there, boys. How am I supposed to fight you if I can't target your rocky shelter? The good part is that when we get a couple boxes into Novice TK, we can go to Dantooine and pull missions as Pistoleer. And we'll be able to get the higher level missions without the penalty of it thinking we're too amateur to do them. So that'll work out really well for us too. Probably make it go faster. TK wasn't a very long class to master anyway. I had the most trouble with Fencer. Mostly because it just doesn't do enough damage. It's just all avoidance focused. Kind of like Pistoleer, but Pistoleer you actually do some damage. Back to the mission terminal. This is pretty much a day in the life of a grinding character. So if you were working on a class, this is what you would do. There's ultra efficient ways to do it, but we're just doing it as you would do it by yourself. If you didn't know anybody on the server or you were newer, so we're trying to play this character like a new character who doesn't know anybody and can't get carried in some of the areas and gaining a bunch of experience. So north. I think the next one we get Bantha Matriarchs. Oh, rock beetles have a ranged attack, so they will be annoying for us. Flareon Assassin, that looks promising. Cannibal Dewback. Yeah, Swordsman took a little bit of time too. But Fencer took most time for me out of all of those. Just basically because your weapons are like hitting things with a toothpick. You just don't do a whole lot of damage. So your spin attacks take longer to kill the nest. And even though you jump around a lot, don't take a lot of damage. So you're never really at risk. You're also never doing huge, huge damage to anything. Once you get mind hit with Swordsman, it's pretty much game over right there. You just really start just tearing things apart. Is that our mission? Yeah, there it is. More Banthas. There we go. Getting closer. Go. Now, mastering a profession in this game is just such a great feeling. You actually feel like you accomplished something. All the years I played World of Warcraft off and on, I just never really felt like I got anywhere after I'm capped out completely. Just wasn't as big of an accomplishment. There's our mission. These guys are hungry. We'll go down there and then we'll run back through them. Reposition. Why do you always go to the right? And that's done. And they're still making noise, even though they're dead. Guess they were going for a Drama Queen Award or something. For best death in a video game. Farmer? You don't look like a farmer. It's a front. Alright, where'd that put us? 100k of 450k and 113k of 120k. So we're whittling it down. Lots of wounds. What time is it? A little after 10, I guess. All right, here we are back in Tombstone. At our favorite mission terminal. I really think we can do better than that without going to the east. And without taking Dune Lizard missions. South is good. South works. Those aren't ideal anymore. I don't think we need to take out Swarmer Lessing Dewbacks if we're taking out full Dewbacks on the regular. So we can skip those guys.
we need a bigger engine on our speeder bike so we can get up these hills. Is that command anyway? No, that's not it. Yeah, it'd be nice to get four missions at a time. It'd be really handy. But two is okay. There's really a reason why you can only get two as well. It was back when they had that bug where you could take missions that showed up in town limits and got blown up automatically. Immortal one over here. Dang it, I said go this way. No, left. Don't always go right. Too predictable. They're onto your secrets. Oops, do not want that. There we go. Next mission. Are we? I think one more mission should do it. Or one more set of missions. So that'd be like 50k, I think. Or close. One or two. Find a good flat spot. Take him out. That works right there. A little awkward, but we'll work with it. Really like when you get knocked down and you stand up automatically.
There we go. Where'd that put us? Pretty darn close. 20. Well, 2,000 experience to go. Can't ask for much better than that. I think we're going to get this box trained up and actually go do the training, and then we're going to call it a day. Because we'll be almost 3 hours in for this. Totally worth it, though. So we'll get that Stances 3 box trained after we do two more missions. Got our money's worth out of our buffs at least. And if we don't stop soon, these are going to run out in about 25 minutes. So we were at the end of it anyway. Geez, did we make some progress tonight? I have a feeling when we master Pistoleer, Smuggler is just going to go insanely fast. So I don't know if he even uses as much experience. It's 175, 75, and 175. So that one's the same, this one's low. Mountain Dew back to the west. Bocats. That one's gonna be too low. Yep. West. Good enough. This should get us there. Can't imagine it wouldn't. And they're not too far away. I'd hate to run this distance, though. So honestly, that'd be quite the long run. I've done it before, many, many times, but doing it on a speeder is so much better. See our missions. Ah, cool. That works. Nice, easy slope. There we go. Come on. almost there. And that did it. Now we just gotta finish up these two missions and head back. Next one. Get their nest targeted. And van shot. Pew, 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 pew. This is the official pew, pew gun. Alrighty then, back to Isley. Talk to our buddy the trainer. I really miss the fast travel shuttle. Sometimes it's one of those things you never knew you needed till you could use it, and then you could use it and you never wanted to stop using it. Basically what it lets you do is transfer to one of the NPC cities from like all the way out here. There we go. So you would call it, and the shuttle would fall down on your head, pick you up, and drag you back to town. It was kind of cool. Yeah, try not to fall asleep. It's actually kind of warm in here, so that's not helping. Not gonna have that problem soon. It's gonna be very cold. So I'm redesigning my recording area. So I'll be able to do a more variety of things here. Making it so I still have the computer to record the gameplays and the other stuff on, and the music, and all that. And what I'm doing is I'm going to cordon off part of the room and put a table there with a nice tablecloth on it and set it up so I can use my GoPro with a tripod and a microphone to do like tech stuff and unboxings and things like that. I probably won't do many unboxings, but I don't order that much stuff anymore. But you never know. I mean, there could be a case where I get something cool. I really would like to have done an unboxing on my Akai USB MIDI keyboard controller. It was kind of neat. The box was put together really well, so it would have been nice to show you guys that. Don't need that since I'm not going to get attacked anymore. Pistoleer trainer. Are you interested in learning stances 3? Yes. And now let's hit the cantina to... Yeah, we can skip that. We'll go to the med center. Now we just gotta do stances 4 and grips 4, and then we can start on that last tree. Yeah, call shuttle was just amazing. I thought it was really stupid when I first read it. Because I'm like, why would anybody want to do that? And then I got it and I was playing around with it and I'm like, this is awesome. Whoever invented this is a genius. Okay, so where are you going to go sit in the med center for a few minutes and heal? So basically, what we accomplished today was pistol grips 2 and 3. And stances 3. And we got a ways through grips 4. We're about halfway done with grips 4. But our buffs are going to run out really soon. And I'm not paying a rebuff just so we can do a few more missions. We're getting ready to hit 3 hours here. And I definitely cap these out no more than 3 hours. So... anything more than that is, well, nobody's going to watch a 4-hour video unless they actually watched it. But we're making great progress. Really good progress. Once we finish stances 4, our combat experience is going to start going into striking. So that'll be good because at the rate we're gaining experience, getting this done, this will get this done before we start these. So we're going to get all of our defense, acuity, melee defense, range defense, unarmed, accuracy, center of being, and toughness before we even start working on these boxes. And then we're going to start working on these and work through them, and I'll come up with a way of progression for this. No matter what, your meditation techniques are going to go last, so... they're irrelevant to your combat skill for the most part. So this is the last one. We can ignore meditative techniques and striking because those are going to be gone. So we just have to look at these and determine which is best. So we'll do that later. But tomorrow we should have another combat video and we should make more progress in Pistoleer and really on our way towards that last line to start Smuggler. And once we do that, Smuggler should just fly by. And then we'll be done with pistols and we can finish up our last class.
Yeah, it was a great night for experience. I'm not really sure what happened. Maybe it was just because we were so conversational that it just kind of flew by, but we did really good. So I'm happy. Now Andrew has to catch up. We'll see how he does. Because he was talking about he was going to get fan shot yesterday, and I did not get a chance to see if he did. But if he didn't, then he's going to be behind. So he's going to have to catch up. But I will talk to you guys tomorrow. Tomorrow, I should probably start either tomorrow or over the weekend. All the social media links will start to go up in the descriptions of the video, so you can look in those if you want to check out more about me personally. If you get on my Facebook, you can see the accident I had last year. It was pretty dramatic, so I'm sure you'll enjoy that if you like car carnage. And you can read the story behind that and the other stuff that I do. So I will get those worked out and going for the weekend. We've got a bunch of stuff we're going to work on this weekend, so it's going to be a busy weekend for videos. Bunch of stuff you guys should enjoy, so definitely subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any. And like the video if you enjoyed it. This is going in an archive, so it will show up about 3 hours, I guess. And anybody who missed it can review it again. And hopefully you enjoy it. This was a great episode, very productive. Tomorrow we're probably going to switch to Dantooine and maybe do even better. So that'll be cool. But I appreciate you guys watching. Thanks for sticking with me. And I will catch you guys tomorrow. Send me your comments or questions, and we will get to those as we can. And I will talk to you guys later. Y'all have a good night.